This is News Vision for Monday, October 16th. With flu season just around the corner, the Midland Health Department is still waiting for its share of the vaccine. Shots were ordered in January by City of Midland Health Administrator Sal Garcia, who said the health department has been in weekly contact with the company responsible for sending the shipment of shots. Garcia says Midland is, quote, being held hostage by the pharmaceutical company. Flu season generally peaks in January and February. A 57-year-old Midland man was killed in an early morning traffic accident Sunday. Walter McLean died when his truck traveling eastbound on Wadley struck a traffic signal pole. An autopsy has been ordered. McLean was believed not to be wearing a seatbelt when the accident occurred. Hawaiians are digging out this morning following the big shake Sunday. A 6.5er centered near Kailua Kona on the east coast of the Big Island. More in this report from the Associated Press.
A lot of people will be cleaning up in Hawaii on Monday. That's because a strong series of earthquakes jolted the island early Sunday. The U.S. Geological Survey says the first quake had a preliminary magnitude of 6.6, and it hit 10 miles just north-northwest of Kailua Kona, a town on the west coast of the Big Island. It was followed by several strong aftershocks. The tremors knocked items off store shelves, caused rock walls to crack and crumble, nearly knocked this shed over a cliff, and knocked out power to much of the state, leaving motorists without streetlights at intersections. No deaths were reported, but several minor injuries were, and Hawaii's governor predicts many other injuries went unreported.
I'm certain there are other people who have cuts and bruises because throughout the region, as well as other parts of the state, things in people's homes were falling off the shelves, pictures, mirrors, televisions, books.
Governor Lingle issued a disaster declaration for the entire state. The quakes caused problems for tourists. About 3,000 people were evacuated from hotels on the Big Island due to damage there. Other tourists just got a fright.
Yeah, we were just having a little recreation here in Maui when we were rudely awakened this morning around 7 o'clock. We're Californian. Two of us are Californian, so it was nothing new for us. But I would say it felt like a big one.
The biggest inconvenience for many was power outages. In downtown Waikiki, the skyline was a blanket of dark buildings.
No, it isn't working.
Phone service was spotty. Officials say the power is being restored quickly.
Other than a good shake from Mother Nature, everything is back to normal. Our guests were really more or less had some trouble with getting elevators to and from lobby areas as those were brought down. But once we were back up and operational, everything was great.
Power outages did cause problems for airports, though, and led to some flight cancellations.
Right now, Honolulu International Airport is on auxiliary power right now. This is enough for emergency, but not enough to power the whole airport. So what we're going to do is we're going to clear out or flush out the passengers who are already here. The problem is it's going to take a while to process them. We're going to have to hand search the baggage. We're going to have to get them onto the plane via the hard ramps, not the usual taxiways between the gates and the plane, but get them on the runway and get them onto the plane.
And at the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center on Oahu, scientists said the quake was noteworthy.
Basically, the earth creaked and groaned underneath the weight of the Hawaiian Islands and produced an earthquake, and it was a surprisingly large earthquake for that part of the Big Island, the northwest coast.
The quakes could create some big waves in the region, but there was no risk of a tsunami.
Fortunately, it generated only a very small tsunami. It was only 4 inches high at Kauai High.
Aftershocks could continue for weeks. Judy Boysha at the Associated Press.
In today's My West Texas section, read about the City of Midland's redesigned website and also our interview with the writers of JessicaSwell.com, their first ever. On our website today, tell us if you plan to receive a flu shot this year when they do come in. Over the weekend, over 300 of you voted on your favorite 1950s-era situation comedies by a large margin. I Love Lucy with 40% and Leave It to Beaver with 39% ruled the top of that reader poll. This Friday, we'll post a final reader poll on the subject based on the favorites from each decade from the 1950s through the 90s. That'll do it for this News Vision for Monday. I'm Jimmy Patterson.